the bioinformatics community has always been a champion of open science and open data, and we've seen this in a lot of the global collaborations that they've been a part of. But over the last few years, we've seen a shift in this as companies become more cooperative between each other. And there's also been a shift in funding for academic institutions. You're seeing more and more collaborations between academia, industry, and these have been of the form where results have gone into the public domain or been made accessible for everybody to use after. For example, the results from the Open Targets Initiative, which is a large collaboration between several pharmaceutical companies, the Wellcome Sanger Institute and Emble EBI to identify drug targets, have seen several publications to date. And these publications are being consumed not just by other pharmaceutical companies, but also by academics to answer questions such as, what are the mechanisms behind cancer? We also see the Open Targets platform, which is a software platform, being used by pharma companies everywhere because it's open source, it's available for everyone to use, and companies are using this internally and sometimes even deploying internal versions and building on the platform for their own purposes. We're also seeing companies coming together to work on projects such as the UK Biobank and fund the sequencing of 500,000 individuals and make the results of this available for everybody to access. So of course, there's a number of challenges in working this way. Not all institutions, either in the private sector or in public institutes, are used to working this way. This way of working, this form of close collaboration, really needs people to come together to share knowledge, to share data, and then actually work towards making data available. For this kind of close collaboration to work on a day-to-day basis, we need really good operational models that put into place the right frameworks around intellectual property, legalities, and even the right kinds of governance that still enable open science outputs while still enabling companies to profit from this kind of work. At Emble EBI, we've been working with companies for 25 years. And over this time, we've developed a lot of experience in understanding company problems and developing the right solutions for these, whether it's open data resources, the tools, or even driving community standards. We've also been part of large international collaborations, often taking on the role as a data coordination partner. So again, we've been dealing with big data and turning this data into knowledge and making that available for other people to reuse. One thing that we see is a key success factor for these kinds of collaborations is actually co-location, where industry scientists can sit side by side with EBI scientists and work together on problems, sharing their knowledge, coming at the problem from these different mindsets, and then creating solutions that really work. There are so many unanswered questions in biology, and if you really want to find new medicines or better ways of producing food, we need to come together as a scientific community and work on these big questions together. So sharing data, working closely together is what I see as the way forward, and I really hope it's the way that we work together in the future.